Hello students, my name is Jacqueline Peter Walsh. You all can call me Jacqueline Teacher. I will be teaching you all social studies. So, today we'll see chapter 1 and the name of our chapter is Globe and Maps. I have written here part 1 because we are going to study only the half part of this chapter today. The next we will be seeing in the next video. So, in this chapter or through this presentation, we will learn about globe, maps, and language of a map. So, let's start. In ancient times, people believed that the earth was flat, and they would fall off from its surface if they traveled to its edge. In around 500 BCE, a Greek scholar, Pythagoras, proposed that the earth is round. In the modern era, satellite images of the earth also proved that the shape of the earth is like an orange or sphere. We can comprehend the shape of the earth with the help of a globe. Now let us see what is a globe. In a common or a simple language, we can say it is a replica. Replica means model of the earth. Globe is a replica of earth. We can see the shape and location of the continents, oceans and seas through globe. Only half part of the globe is visible at a time. After rotating it, we can see the other half of it. Now let us see what the advantages of a globe. Globe helps us to understand how day and night occur. It also helps us to understand how seasons are caused. It is also useful to learn the features of the earth. So, with advantages, there are some limitations of a globe. So, let us see what are the limitations. Globe does not give a detailed information. It is difficult to carry as it occupies a lot of space. A specific area cannot be enlarged on a globe. And the fourth is, it cannot give the correct idea of the distances between two places. So, I want you all to learn these advantages and limitations of a globe. Moving forward, we have maps. Now, let us see what is a map. A map is a two-dimensional representation of the earth on the flat surface. Or we can also say it is an outline of any place or area. Advantages of maps. We can get more specific and detailed information through maps. Maps are easier to use and carry around. It can display various types of information such as population, densities, or natural resources. We can also draw a map to indicate mountains, rivers, populations, crops, wildlife, forests, and minerals. Now let us see limitations of maps. A map has its own limitations. The first is, the Earth's spherical shape cannot be shown accurately on a flat surface. Second, map distort the shapes and sizes of the landform. Now, moving forward to the third point, we have language of a map. To understand the information given on a map, we use a variety of signs, symbols, and colors. These are called the language of a map. In this map, we can see many signs and symbols. These all are helpful for us. So, with this, today we have ended the first part of our chapter. So, homework today for you all is, you all have to find out more signs and symbols and write or draw them in your notebook. And second homework is, you all have to try to draw an outline map of India. Make sure the drawing which you do is very neat and clean. Thank you.